what's been brewing for the last week. I don't know if how many of you guys saw this in IndieWire, but there's a director who did very well at Sundance this past year. His name is Lance Hammer. Mm-hmm. He had a deal with IFC, and he walked away from the deal, supposedly amicably, but because he just wasn't going to make any money. Distributors take their money. And he just knew that if he couldn't make any money, no one would ever allow him to make another movie again, because the first one didn't do well, so why should you make another one? So what do you think about that whole drama that's kind of starting out?
Yeah, I don't know what to think of it. When I was at Sundance, I saw a couple movies, and I'm going to meet with one of the producers on Thursday, actually, because I was sort of, it was very inspiring on one hand and puzzling on the other hand, that there were movies like Ballast, like Frozen River, that are so small, and that they got purchased, they sold. And I don't know what to make of that. That's encouraging, except that they still get lost, because IFC doesn't have money to build them. Sony Pictures Classics, I don't know how they're going to do a Frozen River. I can't imagine how they're going to do it. I can't imagine they're going to do well, to be honest with you. I hate putting that out there, but I just can't. So I don't really understand the voices out there are like, you know, independent film is dead. That's the mantra, which is so upsetting. And at the same time, then those movies are selling, and you have Quentin Tarantino up there at the awards, giving, you know, Frozen River an award and basically going on and on about the movie for like 10 minutes, about how amazing, excited he was. And, you know, and I watched him, and I watched him afterwards at the party, and I watched him interacting with everybody, and, you know, and I was like, it was a beautiful thing, because took a lot of time to hang out with a lot of people and embrace them as filmmakers. But of course, he's a filmmaker. He doesn't represent the business. So there's a real separation, and I don't really know. There has always been, but it seems like the gap is even wider now, and everything costs so much money anymore. And I don't, you know, the more money Batman or every other movie makes, harder it is for us. Not that I begrudge them, I love those movies, but it just feels like unless somebody fails with all that stuff, then they're going to look to other people like us. But when they're doing all of that, because, you know, I don't know if you saw in the LA Times about a month or so ago, there was an article, I won't get on this whole trend, but this article about women directors and how, you know, it had people like Catherine Hardwick was talking to women producers. Stacey Snyder, Polly Clough, big, you know, producers, studio producers, that were women talking in the article, and basically, we don't get to direct those movies. That's just the way it goes. And the article was sort of off-putting because it was like, well, you know, these producers were quoted as saying, well, women don't want to direct those movies. We don't want to show up and tell terrible people what to do. Meanwhile, that's what we do with television movies anyway. But, you know, I'm like, oh, well, we don't want to do popcorn movies. And I'm like, who are they talking for? And then, you know, Catherine Hardwick's like, well, all my director friends are men. And it's like, what is going on here? So I won't go off on that, but it just seems like things get wider and wider, and they have to come back on some level. But the more crappy films get made, the worse it's going to be. So I really think everyone needs to look at what they're doing. Slow down, make some good product that people are interested in. I mean, it's sort of miraculous that the movies have been out in the world on a level. And it continues because of the internet. It continues to be alive. You know what I mean? Which is amazing.
Yeah. But that's what everybody's saying, there's too much product out there. I mean, some people have said that. I mean, then other people say, no, it's never enough. It's crazy. So.
These companies want product for no money, so people, we can't make a living doing it, which is the real problem. So that, you know, and I'm one of the very fortunate people that gets to direct television, so I get to make a living as a director. A lot of people don't.
And that's what's so great. It's a job. It's you go there and you get paid a salary. So I think that's why some of these folks find hear about that, right? I guess you want to hear about what it's like to work in television, to get a job, you know, as a director. Are there many women directors in television?
According to the DGA, 4% of the directors of television are women. I'm not here to like discourage it.
It's just
daunting, and I think it's more to just let. I mean, I wanted to come here because I think it's just really important to be truthful about things, but also to just say, don't take any shortcuts. Like, work your ass off, because that's what I have done, and I know, and Nestor sees it, and he's a part of it too. It's like, it's a constant commitment to work. You know what I mean? I mean, that's what it is. That's what being a director is. That's what being a producer and filmmaker is. It's like a commitment to, that's the priority. Rejection, none of that matters. It's like, do it, that's what you do. And, you know, I just realized a few months ago that, like, I work so hard, making no money most of the time, just so I can have a window of, like, you know, 3 weeks where I'm on a TV show here and there. That sustains me the rest of the time. But if I really add up all of the hours that I'm working in my life for what, I'm not in it for the money, you know. But at the same time, I'm not going to a 9-to-5 job every day and ready to shoot myself either. Do you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. I'm not saying there's anything wrong with that. I'm saying me. For me, I don't work.
And you have an agent?
I have an agent, yeah. I have an agent.
How did you find your agent? Is that always necessary? Is
to be a
television director,
how
they package you.
Yeah, they sort of, well, I ended up first, my first agent from Sundance, and a manager, and then I've had many since then. So I'm happy where I am now, Paramount. I think that as far as where you guys are at, I think that what's important is to make a really kick-ass short. I don't know what like movies you make here. Shorts, right?
Yeah.
So to really focus on that, and the best you can, like not waste any time. And again, it's from the writing on, the acting on, like don't take one element of it for granted. And push as hard as you can to make it as good as you can and get it into the festivals. Get it to whatever festivals you can. Get it out to the festivals in California. Get it to the festival in New York. And that's, you know, if it doesn't work with that, then do it again, and do it better, learn your lesson. Because I think that's the only way they pay attention, is if you get a short, you win some kind of award, then you can get on some agent's radar. But until then, it's, you know, it's very difficult. Because, I mean, you know, just as a client, it's very difficult, and I'm always bombarding them probably too much, but because they don't have a gazillion clients. You know, so it's hard to get their attention on any level. Forget about if you haven't done anything yet, or you have something that hasn't done anything in the world or no one's seen. You know, you have to get it out there.